Okay guys, so we are going to solve another radical equation, and we're gonna just start straight away. This one's actually ready to go because the first thing we want to do is make sure that the radical expression is isolated, and the radical expression is the square root of 11x plus 48, and that is by itself on the left hand side of the equation, so it's good to go. We can start by squaring both sides. So we'll take the original equation and square both sides. This allows us to drop the house or the radical on the left-hand side, and it will have us FOIL the x plus 6 expression on the right-hand side. So setting up for the FOIL, you could write these separately, or you might know how to FOIL in your head, which is fine. We are gonna multiply those two x's together and I get x squared. We have an inner 6x, we have an outer 6x, and 6 times 6 is 36. And then we will combine like terms and get a 12x in the middle. And now we have the 11x plus 48 and the x squared plus 12x plus 36. It will help us to collect our like terms all on the right-hand side of this equation because the x squared is already over there. So we're going to subtract the 11x and subtract the 48 to get the terms to the right-hand side of this equation and effectively zero out the left-hand side of this equation. So that gives us 0 is equal to x squared plus x minus 12. And this is factorable. It factors into the expressions x minus 3 and x plus 4 because the negative 3 and the positive 4 multiply to give negative 12, and when you add those together you get the 1, which is the coefficient of the x term. Setting each of these equal to 0 and pulling the roots out gives us x is equal to 3 or x is equal to negative 4. So we're going to check these because we did square the equation. So we'll check x equals 3 first, and we're going to check that in the original expression, the original equation. So you're going to plug 3 in where there's x in the original equation. And that gives us the square root of 81 is equal to 9, which is a true statement. So that is a good solution. And then we're going to check the x is equal to negative 4 and plug that negative 4 into the original equation. And that gives us the square root of 4 is equal to 2, which is also a true statement, which means that is also a good solution. So the two solutions for this radical equation are x is equal to 3 and x is equal to negative 4.